the Board of Supervisors meeting to order. Please rise for one more silent prayer followed by the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I'd like to request the clerk call the roll.
Bassin?
Here.
Wygill?
Here.
Bratton?
Here.
Benvenuto?
Here.
Stats?
Here.
Keaveney?
Here.
Mayor?
Here.
Lowell?
Here.
Riley?
Happy Wednesday.
Eldridge? Bury?
Here.
Chipkowski?
Here.
Ligonia?
Here.
Sterling?
Here.
Mia?
Here.
Kamides?
Here.
Musman?
Here.
Scalera? Guzzi?
Here.
Teal?
Here.
Morel?
Here.
Knott?
Here.
Skoda?
Here.
3225 present, 310 absent. We have a quorum.
Thank you. I'd like to ask the, to open the public hearing on Local Law 3 of 2018 and ask the clerk to read the notice.
Please take notice that the Columbia County Board of Supervisors shall hold a public hearing for the proposed Local Law 3 of 2018 prohibiting the sale and possession of sparkler devices in Columbia County on the 13th day of June 2018 at 7:30 p.m. in the Board of Supervisors Chambers, First Floor, 401 State Street, Hudson, New York, 12534. Copies of said proposed local law are available in the office of the Clerk of the Board of Supervisors. By the order of the Clerk of the Board, Kelly S. Picaro, dated May 29th, 2018.
Thank you. Are there any comments from Board of Supervisors members? Supervisor Kamides?
I'd like to thank everyone for getting this resolution this far, and I'm happy to be looking at ways to improve safety in the county, especially for volunteer firefighters. I've been researching this issue, and one of the peculiar things about this resolution compared to the studies I've seen is it's such a small geography of a county, and I wasn't able to find any studies that really talked about what happens when you ban sparkling devices within a county when there's available sparkling devices so close by. I know that many of my constituents have contacted me and are really concerned about prohibiting specifically sparklers. And I'm really wondering if prohibition of sparklers is a good use of resources, especially given our limited police and court time. Are we expecting people to call the police if a neighbor is using a sparkler? And if so, would we expect the police to actually go and take the time to issue a ticket to someone who's using a sparkler, say, in their backyard? So I really question whether or not this would be a good use of resources. At the same time, if we're not expecting us to enforce these laws, I'm questioning whether or not we should be creating a new law that we don't even intend to enforce. So I would really like to hone in on whether or not we should be prohibiting the possession of sparklers specifically in this resolution. And regardless of how this resolution turns out, I would also recommend that we do some education around fire safety for sparklers and fireworks. Because regardless of whether or not we prohibit them, they're still going to be used, and I think people need to know how to use them safely.
Thank you. Supervisor Nair?
I'd like to say on the other half that right now, sparklers and other stuff is illegal anyways, whether people call the sheriff or not. It's an enforcement issue and where they have to be at what time. We've had letters here from the fire commissioners, a letter from the fire departments. I don't go out and fight these fires, but these firemen put their life on the line every time they got to go out on a fire. And they're going to find it. I will support them in my vote to ban sparklers. We really need to take into account who's got to go there. God forbid there's something happens. That's just my point.
Thank you. Any other supervisors? Supervisors?
Mr. Chairman, I'd just like to say, last time this was brought up, we had a vote. I was against banning sparklers at that point. I certainly feel the same way again this time around. I feel it's a loss of revenue to the county. for sales tax, and this can be set up and sold and possessed in the county, since other surrounding counties, Ulster, Dutchess, Green, are all setting up, selling these tents and selling all this product and collecting sales tax right across the borders, or bringing it back over here and using it. To a couple points, are we going to enforce this? I mean, I can't see somebody calling the cops and then the cops going out and issuing a ticket for somebody using a sparkler. So, my feeling is this is going to make innocent people feel like criminals, and there's absolutely no reason for this law to be put in effect. There's ways. I know the fire company, the fire districts have been calling up and asking supervisors to vote and support the fire companies. There's a way to do that other than passing a law like this. I know there's a lot of statistics and studies that have been passed around. The numbers are definitely out of context for countywide again. And I certainly do not think that at this point we need to pass this law and again make honest people feel like criminals. I just don't see it. So I'm going to vote against this.
Thank you, Supervisor Stiles. Any other supervisors? Any other supervisors? Any other supervisors? Solicit public comments? Would anyone from the public like to comment? Would anyone from the public like to comment? Okay, with that, I'm going to close the public hearing, and I'm going to ask for a roll call vote on Local Law 3, 2018.
Just remember, if you're voting A in favor of the local law, passing the local law, that would ban sparklers. If you want to allow sparklers, you would vote nay or against the local law. Unfortunately, the state is kind of set up as a double negative, so I just wanted to clarify.
Bassin?
Yes.
Weigelt?
No.
Bratton?
Yes.
Benvenuto?
Yes.
Stats?
No.
Keevney?
Yes.
Nair?
Yes.
Long?
Yes.
Riley?
No.
Eldridge? Bury?
No.
Chipkowski?
Yes.
Ligonia?
Yes.
Sterling?
No.
Mia?
No.
Chimides?
No.
Mussman?
No.
Scalera? Guzzi?
Yes.
Teal?
No.
Morrell?
Yes.
Knott?
Yes.
Skoda?
Yes.
A, 1084 nay. 310 absent. The local law passes.
Thank you very much. Okay, I need a motion to pay the bills, accept the treasurer's report, and file the minutes within the clerk's office.
So moved.
I'll second that motion.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Carried. I'd like to request the clerk read the resolutions.
Resolution 202 of 2018 by Supervisor Lull, 203 by Chipkowski, 204 by Bassin, 205 by Lull, 206 by Weigelt, 207 by Grattan, 208 by Keevney, 209 by Mia, 210 by Lull, 211 by Supervisor Chipkowski.
Supervisor Chipkowski.
Mr. Chairman, I'm pleased to offer these resolutions for adoption.
Second. All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
Resolution 212 of 2018 by Supervisor Bassin, 213 by Chimides, 214 by Weigel, 215 by Grattan, 216 by Keevney, 217 by Mia, 218 by Lull, 219 by Chipkowski, 220 by Bassin, 221 by Knott, 222 by Supervisor Weigel.
Supervisor Weigel.
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to authorize these resolutions.
Second.
All in favor?
Something like that.
Yeah. You got it. We know what you wanted.
Okay. Resolution 223, 2018 by Supervisor Grattan, 224 by Keevney, 225 by Mia, 226 by Chipkowski, 227 by Bassin, 228 by Knott, 229 by Weigelt, 230 by Grattan, 231 by Supervisor Keevney.
Supervisor Keevney.
Mr. Chairman, I offer these resolutions for adoption.
Second the motion.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Carried.
Resolution 232 of 2018 by Supervisor Mia, 233 by Lull, 234 by Chimides, 235 by Bassin, 236 by Supervisor Knott.
Supervisor Knott.
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to offer these resolutions for adoption.
Second.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Carried. Thank you. Do any supervisors have any business to bring before the board? With that, I have a couple of chair appointments. There are two openings on the College Board of Trustees, and I'm going to be appointing Mary Ann Lee to a 7-year term and Allison Toski to a 1-year term to fill out a remainder of the term. Okay? And with that, I want to give Ron Caponera 5 minutes to talk about the town budget comparisons.
Thank you.
So, nearly every year, you guys got familiar with this town comparison as performed. What I do is take a summer intern and just take the information that you supervise. This really only applies to the towns, not the city of Hudson. I take your budgets that you submit for us, and that information from your budget goes on here as a comparison. However, over the past few years, some of the supervisors have come to me and want to take a more detailed look at what's behind some of the numbers. So what we developed with my intern is basically a questionnaire survey that I'm going to be sending out. And I'll do it manually. You can take this home. I'll put another one in your mailbox. It's set up to go to Google Docs. There's a lot of ways you can provide me with information. But it asks pertinent questions that you ask me all the time. If you group salaries together, as you know, on your budgets, you know, what's individual council numbers?